When I was a kid, I often had the same nightmares. It was about this man standing in my room, looking at me. I was convinced that he came in from the attic. I shared a bedroom with my brother at the time, and when I had this dream, it freaked my brother out in the middle of the night a couple of times. I'm an adult now, and that horrible nightmare is just a distant memory now. Damn, that's deep. Oh. Someone's calling. Where'd my phone be? It should be in my room. I would never leave my phone not with me. I'm not gonna like this. It's already a game that I hate. Oh no. Why is my phone just down here? Hey brother, I just wanted to let you know that we arrived home safely. Thank you for the invitation. We had a great time. It was nice to catch up. I also feel like I have to apologize for Lily's behavior, but you know how kids are and their imagination. She was probably tired as well. See you later. Take care. Okay, now what? It's getting late, but I should probably clean up first. You're right. I walked this slow through my house? Let's start cleaning. It looks really clean. I don't know what you're talking about. Oh, the plate's probably right. Clean table. Today, my brother came to visit. He brought his family along with his wife and their 7-year-old daughter. Her name is Lily. Technically, she's my niece. It's been a while since I last seen them, so we spent about half an hour catching up with each other, just talking. After a while, I noticed that Lily was really uninterested. I don't blame her after all. Adult talking about everyday stuff is probably the most boring stuff for a child. I'm a pretty good uncle, so I offered to let her watch TV upstairs. Showed her all the cartoon channels and left her up to watch TV there. Left her there to watch some TV away from the boring adult stuff. She was grateful. Was she? I feel like she saw something upstairs. Oh, I just put these dishes. The night went on. It seemed like everyone had a good time. Dinner was ready, so I was about to go upstairs to go get Lily to eat with us. That's when all of a sudden, Lily ran downstairs screaming. Looked absolutely terrified. It took her a couple minutes before she could speak. But then finally she said this. There was a man upstairs, staring at me from the doorway. Confused, perhaps a bit frightened, we all went upstairs. Searched everything. Checked the attic as well, only to find nothing. Eventually, my brother dismissed Lily's story and claimed she was probably getting tired, and soon after, they left for the night. I'm once completely alone in my house, and Lily's story sounds too familiar. Okay. Yeah, I should probably go to sleep now, right? Time to go get some sleep. Yeah, pretty tired. It's been a long day today. Good thing there's no one in the attic, though. According to Lily's story, this is where the man was standing, looking straight at her from this doorway, before returning to the attic, just like in my dreams. Oh, man. Oh, my. I love this game. Oh man. This door wasn't open. I washed it open. My ears, my ears. Oh! Stupid, there's nothing up here. Oh, must have just been silly. My brain must have been playing tricks on me. Why do I have to do this? Going to bed. Please don't wake up in the middle of the night. Sometimes a strange noise at night keeps you awake. Then you anxiously search for the cause, but you won't find anything. And you question it once again. And you question it once again. Is the man in the attic real? Stop! Stop! Uh-oh. Oh, man. Fear is subjective, but it's not uncommon to be afraid of men in the attic or men in the basement, perhaps men under your bed. Oh. Thank you for playing my specific fear, the man in the attic. No problem, man. Where's the jump scare? Oh, okay. That game made me so anxious. I don't even know. I thought, oh, I'm so happy there wasn't no jump scare. I was not ready for this today. Well, this game is called The Man in the Attic. Goodbye.